हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल केम्बासिस। म्यूकोरमाइकोसिस और ब्लैक फंगस इन्फेक्शन केसेस कंटिन्यू टू रेज अक्रॉस स्टेट्स इन इंडिया। रिपोर्ट सजेस्ट दैट केस लोड्स हैव बीन राइजन अप बाय वोपिंग 32% इन द रिसेंट वीक। एमिड्स ऑल ऑफ दिस, द मोस्ट अफेक्टेड वंस हैव बीन द रिसेंटली रिकवर्ड COVID-19 पेशेंट्स who have been thronging back to the hospitals only to seek further treatment for a much scarier and fatal illness. So friends, in this video I will discuss what is this mucormycosis or black fungus and what are the symptoms of this disease and how we could prevent or cure this disease. So all these aspects will be discussed in this video. Friends, mucormycosis is a serious but rare fungal infection caused by a group of molds called mucormycetes. These molds live throughout the environment. Mucormycosis mainly affects people who have health problems or take medicines that lower the body's ability to fight germs and sickness. It most commonly affects the sinus or the lungs after inhaling fungal spores from the air. It can also occur on the skin after a cut, burn or other type of skin injury. Friends, this mucormycosis can be divided into 3 to 4 types. The first one is called sinus or brain mucormycosis, which is an infection in the sinus that can spread to the brain. This form of mucormycosis is most common in people with uncontrolled diabetes and in people who have had a kidney transplant. Another one is called pulmonary mucormycosis, which is most common type of mucormycosis in people with cancer and in people who have had an organ transplant or a stem cell transplant. Then there is gastrointestinal mucormycosis, which is more common among young children than adults, especially premature and low birth weight infants less than 1 month of age, who have had antibiotics, surgery or medications that lower the body's ability to fight germs and sickness. Then there is another one which is called skin mucormycosis, which occurs after the fungi enters the body through a break in the skin. This is the most common form of mucormycosis among the people who do not have weakened immune system. Now friends, the question is where mucormycosis comes from. Mucormycetes, the group of fungi that causes mucormycosis, are present throughout the environment, particularly in soil and in association with decaying organic matter such as leaves, compost piles and animal dung. They are most commonly in soil than in air. Most people come in contact with microscopic fungal spores every day, so it's probably impossible to completely avoid coming in contact with mucormycetes. These fungi aren't harmful to most of the people. However, for people who have weakened immune system, breathing in mucormycetes spores can cause an infection in the lungs or sinus, which can spread to other parts of the body. Friends, the symptoms of mucormycosis depend on where in the body the fungus is growing. As an example, in case of sinus and brain mucormycosis include one-sided facial swelling, headache, nasal or sinus congestion, black lesions on nasal bridge. Similarly, in case of pulmonary mucormycosis, the symptoms include fever, cough, chest pain, and shortness of breath. In case of skin mucormycosis, can look like a blister or ulcer, and the infected area may turn black. Other symptoms include pain, warmth, excessive redness, or swelling around a wound. In case of gastrointestinal mucormycosis, the symptoms included abdominal pain, nausea and vomiting, and gastrointestinal bleeding. So friends, the question is how is mucormycosis can be diagnosed? Healthcare providers consider your medical history, symptoms, physical examinations, and laboratory tests when diagnosing mucormycosis. Healthcare providers who suspect that you have mucormycosis in your lungs or sinus might collect a sample of fluid from your respiratory system to send to a laboratory. Your healthcare provider may perform a tissue biopsy in which a small sample of affected tissue is analyzed in a laboratory for evidence of mucormycosis under a microscope or in a fungal culture. You may also need imaging tests such as CT scan of your lungs, sinus, or other parts of your body, depending on the location of the suspected infection. Friends, it is difficult to avoid breathing in fungal spores because the fungi that causes mucormycosis are common in the environment. There is no vaccine to prevent mucormycosis. For people who have weakened immune system, there may be some ways to lower the chances of developing mucormycosis. Now, it is important to note that although these actions are recommended, they haven't been proven to prevent mucormycosis. The first thing is, try to avoid areas with lots of dust like construction sites. If you can't avoid these areas, wear an N95 respirator while you are there. Avoid direct contact with water-damaged building and flood water after hurricane or natural disaster. Avoid activities that involve close contact to soil or dust, such as yard work or gardening. If this isn't possible, wear shoes, long pants, and long-sleeved shirt when doing outdoor activities such as gardening, yard work, or visiting wooded areas. Wear gloves when handling materials such as soil, moss, or manure. To reduce the chances of developing skin infection, clear skin injuries well with soap and water, especially if they have been exposed to soil or dust. Mucormycosis is a serious infection and needs to be treated with prescription antifungal medicine. These medicines are given through a vein or by mouth. Often, mucormycosis requires surgery to cut away the infected tissue. Friends, mucormycosis is not at all a contagious disease. Early recognition, diagnosis, and prompt administration of appropriate antifungal treatment are important for improving outcomes for patients with mucormycosis. So friends, I hope that you find this video pretty much informative. And if you do like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel Cambiasis. And thank you very much for your kind attention. Bye-bye.